Welcome Priyanka Song Kitchen. Today I am going to show you chicken kofta curry. It will be soft meatballs in smooth gravy. So let's start. So for this recipe, here I have taken around 1 pound of ground chicken, and at first I am going to marinate this chicken. So for that, I am going to add around 1/2 tablespoon of grated ginger and some dry spices like 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, around 1 teaspoon of garam masala powder, around 3 to 4 finely chopped green chilies. Next, around 2 tablespoons of finely chopped cilantro, and also around 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder, and last, salt to taste. Now mixing all ingredients together, and last I'm going to add 1 egg, and again mixing really well. This egg helps to bind. So my mixing is done, and now I'm going to cover it with a plate and leave it for about at least 1/2 hour. So after 1/2 hour, my marinating is done, and now I'm going to make this kofta curry. So to make this kofta curry, here I have taken around 2.5 tablespoons of oil, and my oil is already heated. So now I'm going to add garam masala, one small cinnamon stick, and here I have taken 4 cloves, 6 green cardamoms, and very small pieces of jawetri or mace. Stir it. After around 30 seconds, I'm going to add sliced onion, 1 onion, garlic, also I'm going to add salt to taste. Mix it and now fry it. I will fry it for about 4 to 5 minutes. So after around 5 minutes, you can see that my onion became like nice golden color. At this point, I'm going to add around 1/2 tablespoon of grated ginger and around 1 tablespoon of grated garlic. Now again stir it, and I will fry it for about 1 minute. After 1 minute, I'm going to add tomato, 3 small tomato finely chopped. Mix it and stir it. And also now I'm going to add some dry spices. From dry spices, I'm going to add around 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, around 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, around 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, and 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. Now, at first mixing thoroughly. And I will fry these spices till oil starts to separate from the spices and all raw flavors of spices go away. So keep stirring. And if it, after some time, if it becomes dry, then you can sprinkle some water so your spices won't burn. But now I don't need water anymore. So after a few minutes, you can see that it is not sticking anymore, and oil already has separated from the spices. So my frying is done. So now at first I'm going to turn up the heat, and I will leave it to cool it down, and then I will make a paste of the spices, because for this recipe we need a smooth gravy. So after cooling it down, now I'm going to blend it. So just put it in a blender. Into this I'm going to add around 1/3 cup of plain yogurt. Also I'm going to add little water to blend it. So after blending, you can see this is my smooth paste of spices. So just taking it out, and I want to get maximum out, so I'm going to add little water and then close it and shake it. So I took it out this paste completely from the blender, and so now I'm going to make this curry. And so for that I'm going to pour again this paste in the same pan, and here I'm not using any extra oil because oil is already in this paste. So now I'm going to add around 3 to 4 cups of water. So I have added total 3 cups of water, and now let it boil. So after a few minutes you can see that it has already started to boil. So at this point I'm going to make kofta. So for that just take small amount from this chicken mixture and then put it gently like this. Okay, and now just cover it with a lid and cook it for 15 minutes, and now keep your temperature at medium high, and don't cook your kofta at high temperature. Try to cook it at medium high temperature, so by that way your kofta can get all flavor and taste will be so good which we want. So after 15 minutes, now I'm going to add saffron water. To make this, I soaked pinch of saffron or kesar into warm water and I kept it for a few minutes. Then I got this saffron water. So adding, stir it little bit and again cover it and cook it for about at least 30 minutes. So after around 30 minutes, you can see that gravy became thicker. So my curry is done. So just turn off the heat and take it out. So friends, here is my chicken kofta curry. And you can have it with roti, paratha or rice. So enjoy and see you with my next recipe.